Heyo everybody, Haku here with my review for Citrus Episode 8. Sorry this is a little bit late. Had a ton of stuff to do over the weekend, so didn't really have time to record these until now, though I had notes taken. But I'm recording all the anime reviews Monday morning, and I'm gonna try to get them all posted throughout the day Monday. So I guess just hang with me. Kokoku and Colors will be up after this at some point. But either way, let's talk about Citrus Episode 8. One of the I guess the least great episodes, I still thought it was quite good. But let's go through it. Starting at the beginning, this episode is basically Mei, Yuzu, and Matsuri's date full of drama time. But seriously, going through it when they're just hanging out at the mall in the beginning, one thing that stuck out to me that I really, really loved was how Yuzu throughout the whole thing couldn't stop thinking about Mei. It was so cute and adorable. Matsuri, with all the things she says and the way she acts towards Yuzu, especially at the beginning, and from the flashbacks we see of the little Yuri, of the little Yuzu and Matsuri, I feel like Matsuri probably has some kind of negative or harsh backstory. We might not find out anything about it in detail. We might just find out, oh, her parents weren't very nice to her, they never paid attention to her, and Yuzu was all she had, really. But I feel like there's something deeper, some sort of tragic problem she has that makes her this way. And I think her character becomes a lot more understandable throughout the episode, which is good. But she runs off, creating all these problems, uses these two kids as her minions, and ends up confronting Mei. And we get to learn more about her because she confronts Mei by saying that she thinks that Mei is the one that's playing and messing around with Yuzu, the one that's warping Yuzu, because she remembered who Yuzu was. Yuzu never wanted to be like this, but now she is like this because she's around Mei. So she's sort of blaming the change in her life in somebody that she cared about on Mei, and she thinks, in a way, she's trying to protect Yuzu, I feel like. So I think it becomes a lot more understandable, and you can empathize with the character a lot more knowing that she just thinks that Mei is bad for Yuzu, and she's trying to protect Yuzu from her. And Mei, with her... Mei still needs saving. I keep saying that. She still very much thinks terrible things about herself. And in what she did, she's almost kind of proving Matsuri right, in a way, from the actions that Matsuri gets to see. But it is clear that she cares about Yuzu, and that's the reason Mei is doing all of this. So it's like two people that both care about Yuzu, both going about it in ways that are totally not good for the other. But Yuzu then finally gets back up with Mei and is able to talk to her, and from what I get of her words, it feels like Yuzu feels like she has to take care of Matsuri, like she's her responsibility to protect in a bit of a way, and that's why she's trying to protect her from all this sort of dangerous behavior. And she brings up that she understands why Matsuri's so mad. Matsuri comes here to find that her best friend is totally obsessed with another girl, and even them going on a date to hang out together, the whole time they go to hang out together, but Yuzu doesn't pay Matsuri any attention because she's so focused on Mei. She can't stop thinking about Mei. So she understands why Matsuri's upset, and it does make sense. We have a scene with Drills and the other student council member then. Forget her name. Is it Himiko? Yeah, it's Himiko, I believe. But they sort of set up, they say a class trip is coming in February, so I feel like that sets us up for another arc. I feel like that's going to be an important part of the story, or at least a setting that they get into. Then Mei asks them to be done with all they're doing by Christmas, because it's so cute, because Yuzu told her they were going to do stuff for Christmas. All that was cute. And I think, too, the way that Himiko drills... the way that she handled all this and talked, I feel like she's developed into a good character. Where at first she was that character that was supposed to be driving the wedge between Mei and Yuzu, and she developed into a good character that you can empathize with and that isn't in the way at all, really. She even adds things to the series. Then we have Goofy Harumin, poor Goofy Harumin, getting shut down in the store by Yuzu. And I kind of feel bad for Harmeen, because, like with Matsuri, even worse, really, because Harmeen is nice and isn't doing any of the sketchy bad stuff that Matsuri is, Harmeen just gets completely ignored because Yuzu is so focused on Mei all the time. Then, very end of the episode, Matsuri confronts Mei, and that's where we end. I thought this episode made... I combined those two words. This episode made really good progress for the story moving forward. Happens every week. The story moves at a pretty brisk pace. I didn't think it was the best episode, but I think it's fine because it's all set up. It's all leading somewhere. Matsuri, to me, just wants to protect Yuzu, and she totally has some sort of sad or tragic thing in her backstory. So, as much as what she's doing annoys me a bit, I think it's okay because it's leading somewhere. The setup is all there for it to lead somewhere. That, and I think, you know, if Drills can become a good character, so can Matsuri. There's nothing that is standing in the way there. But either way, I'm giving it 7.5 pervy minions out of 10 because I did think it was good. I think this show has been consistently good. But it wasn't, like, as great as some of the episodes previously have been. So I guess that's it. Either way, if you did like the video, comment down there to tell me what you thought of this episode and what you thought of my thoughts on this episode. Subscribe for more Citrus, tons of other anime and manga and everything else on the channel. Follow on Twitter if you want. I can try to keep you updated there and stuff for the channel. And if you want a link to our Discord server to talk with me, more of us there, just ask and I can give you one. That's it. Thank you once again for watching. I'll see you all next time.